Lex Luger was one of the biggest stars in wrestling.
He brought an attitude.
Lex was a big, giant, muscle guy that looked like He-Man.
His body was a temple.
Vince signed him for the World Bodybuilding Federation.
That was a can't-mess deal. No telling what this guy could be.
They brought him in as the narcissist.
It's like, ooh, that might be kind of neat. I think I can sink my teeth into being a narcissistic bad guy.
But Vince saw him as the next Hulk Hogan.
I don't know if I was ever going to be the guy, but who wouldn't want to be the guy?
He's the American superstar now.
Luger would slay it, the 550-pound champion. Lex Luger has done what no athlete could do.
They had that whole bus tour.
The Lex Express thing was a complete, utter flop.
It was like a curse. It ruined him.
It's easier to be a bad guy. Good guys, it's more responsibility.
It wasn't gonna help, but get fatigued.
I didn't know whether he didn't connect with the people. He could be one of the guys. He couldn't be the guy.
Sometimes we don't realize what we had until it's gone.
The demise of Lex Luger started to happen and things started to go bad for him.
My life had become a total train wreck.
I was there the day that he went paralyzed.
Your heart breaks a little bit for somebody that you know and somebody that's a friend that goes that had to go through what he went through. But on the other hand, he came out of it stronger than ever.
Our wrestling audience, how they relate to us, we're like family. You know, I'd messed up and made a lot of mistakes. They still showed me a lot of love.
She is powerful.
Beth Phoenix, the new WWE Women's Champion.
Beth wanted to be a wrestler. From the time she was, you know, a kid.
She started watching wrestling with my parents.
We liked watching Ivan Putski on the screen.
The Polish power, Ivan Putski!
My grandmother was a very small, very conservative, tiny, petite Polish woman. The only thing that would bring out this wild woman in her was pro wrestling. Watching television with her and her getting down on the ground and pounding her fists and getting super animated. I was like, this is what I want to do and this is all I want to do. I got to figure this out somehow.
Her brother joined a wrestling team and I said, okay. She says, but I want to join. I said, well, you're a girl, so usually there's men wrestling. And she says, well, I will be the first one to be wrestling.
There was no female wrestling team at my school and never had been a female wrestler. I took a deep breath and wrote my name under the male wrestler side of the sports sign-up sheet.
The coach and everybody else kind of tried to talk her out of it, and she refused. She wouldn't give up.
This is what I want to do. I'm not scared. I'm going to do it.
She wanted to show that you can be a woman and you can have muscles and you can exercise and you can do the same thing that boys do.
To be able to say I was a Notre Dame wrestler was a big deal. And adding that at the bottom, I remember taking this in to get embroidered and then being like, wait, what? Because I was not done by females at the time. So that's really special to me. It was a big deal.
When you hear the name Beth Phoenix, I go back to Beth broke glass ceilings for women to be viewed as superstars.
She showed women back then that it's okay to wrestle, it's okay to be strong. And when one door is slammed in your face, you open up another door. When somebody says no, you turn that no into a yes.
She would use her strength, which was her strength. And that's what set her apart. That's what made her different.
I
approach everything differently.
Oh my God, the elevation! It's up!
Martial arts, acrobatics, flips and splits.
That's just me, that's the way I am.
As a kid, I felt that pressure of trying to fit in, just like all the kids, but I hated it. I decided instead of trying to blend in, you know, screw it, I'm gonna be myself. That me became a person of substance that other people could look up to through my accomplishments, through my way of life.
Rob Van Dam making his ECW debut, a well-traveled world-class wrestler.
What you see on camera is pretty much what you see behind the scenes. That's Rob.
You are seriously stressed out.
He got to the top being Rob Van Dam.
What an accomplishment!
Nothing more, nothing less. He did it on his own terms.
Because you guys know, my initials are R.V.
One of a kind.
I remember watching like the Flintstones and the Jetsons, and you'd always see the dad with like the briefcase and the suit on, and he'd have his breakfast and go out the door. Our dad wasn't like that.
No. And I remember like all the kids at school are like, yeah, my dad's the strongest, and it's like, our dad actually was the strongest.
He loved working out. He always wanted to go on an adventure. When we were growing up, all we saw was Davey on TV.
Yeah.
So that's why we referred
always
to him.
Always called him Davey as Davey. Daddy.
Big smile on the face of Davey Boy Smith.
Davey Boy Smith. Davey Boy Smith, victorious.
He was really proud of a lot of the tag team matches him and Dynamite had.
The British Bulldog.
Look at that.
Boy, these Bulldogs are a hell of a class.
They were like brothers. They had each other's backs.
Like a fantastic team, in my opinion, maybe the greatest team I've ever watched.
When the Bulldogs split up, it was like a divorce. Dynamite never talked to him again. He said, you won't make it without me. I knew that Davey had something to prove.
Intercontinental Championship!
SummerSlam 92. That match was just incredible. The fact it was in Wembley Stadium, the fact it was sold out. The British Bulldog, the guy from Britain, was in the main event against Bret the Hitman Hart.
That was the sister who was torn between her brother and her husband.
Wrestling's all I've ever done all my life. I'm trying to provide for my family, my wife, my kids, my future. I'm in the best shape of my life.
He was the greatest British wrestler that the WWE ever had.
Imagine somebody his size be able to move the way that he could move.
The Samoan wrestlers that came in before him were always respected athletes.
The Anoa'i family, probably the most powerful family ever in the history.
He was a title bearer for our family. He will be the most massive presence that our family ever puts out there.
Ronnie and my other nephew, Rikishi, we train them in my backyard. You know, I had a ring in there, and that's how they become wrestlers.
Even though he was the bigger out of all of us, he never quit. He loved professional wrestling.
First time I saw him was in Continental Championship Wrestling as Coquina, and thought, wow, this guy has it. So we knew that we wanted to do something with him.
And it was Sergeant Slaughter who said, why don't you make him a sumo?
They were sorely lacking new monster villains, and he fit the bill.
When you beat the Golden Goose, and you beat him in that fashion, that means you've arrived.
He was an awesome big man. There's not a guy on the crew that didn't respect him.
Yokozuna is the only heel in that period of time that not only kept the belt, but was dominant.
Monster!
Yokozuna backstage was absolutely, totally different.
Hey! He was always in a really good mood.
What do you want?
He wasn't somebody to go out of his way to be a prick or whatever, as long as you brought him his bucket of chicken.
What do you eat for breakfast?
Let's say more than you do.
Yoko liked food.
His weight kept increasing. It became increasingly difficult to travel.
Rodney had to travel first class or, you know, two, sometimes three seats in coach.
They were worried about him having a heart attack in the ring.
We tried dieting. We tried a workout routine with him on the road. Yoko just didn't do it. Yoko did not believe that he had a problem.
He felt like he let us down, but he kept going.
Bonsai! This is the Rodney that's behind the scenes that I only wish that one day that everybody can know the person, the man, the icon, Yokozuna.